The debate around the evolution of modern humans has sparked up some new arguments after new information has come to light about the Homo sapiens fossils that were found in East Africa, better yet, Ethiopia. When looking at the origins of Homo sapiens, better known as modern humans, us, we know that the oldest remains on record have been found at Djebel Irhoud in Morocco. They date to approximately 315,000 years ago. I would like to note that the fossils from Morocco that are the oldest that we currently know of are being contested by anthropologists as they do not believe these fossils to have belonged to Homo sapiens. So there is some debate about that, but that's not for this video. With that said, for a long time, it was thought that the oldest remains were found in Ethiopia at the Kibish Omo site, dated to approximately 195,000 years ago. Well, on January 12, 2022, a new paper was published in Nature with more information and new dates on the Kibish Omo site. This pushes back the timeline considerably by at least 35,000 years. My name is Kaylee, and in this video we're going to take a look into the oldest Homo sapien remains found in the area of Ethiopia in East Africa. There are only 8 sites in the entirety of Africa that have revealed to contain possibly early anatomically modern Homo sapiens fossils from the late Middle Pleistocene, which lasted approximately from 350,000 to 130,000 years ago. So let's take a quick look into the Omo Kibish site, or Kibish Omo site, depending on which article you pick, which is a geological formation located in southwestern Ethiopia, where in 1967 Homo sapiens fossils were found. Omo 1 refers to the group of fossils that were found by the late Kenyan paleoanthropologist Richard Leakey, who unfortunately passed away on January 2, 2022. These fossils were not believed to be older than 195,000 years, but new research into the geochemical fingerprints of a thick layer of ash found above the sediments containing the fossils showed that these fossils were deposited before the eruption of a volcano approximately 230,000 years ago. So the way these fossils are dated is through the use of single crystal isotope dating applied to stratigraphically associated volcanic ash beds, otherwise known as tephra beds. The volcanic remains were dated by collecting pumice rock samples from the tephra beds and grinding them to sub-millimeter size. Each volcanic eruption on the planet has its own fingerprint, an evolutionary story below the surface that shows the path that the magma followed. Once you've crushed the pumice rock, you free the minerals within, and that makes it able for researchers to date them and identify the chemical signature of the volcanic glass that holds the minerals together. The tephra beds at the Omo Kibish site have now revealed a date that the volcanic eruption occurred at least 233,000 years ago, which means that the fossils in the sediment underneath the tephra beds date to at least the same age. But as you can imagine, they are older than the volcanic eruption, as the fossils were already in or on the ground when the eruption occurred, as they are found underneath the tephra beds and not within or above. So this new information brings to light that the possibility of the Djebel Irhoud fossils being Homo sapiens are much greater than previously thought. It shows that the anthropologists that did not want to believe that Homo sapiens could have walked the Earth 300,000 years ago were wrong, as this only makes it seem more probable. This new information is much more in line with the Djebel Irhoud fossils, and it tightens the gap between the two locations, even though they are on quite opposite ends of the continent, with Djebel Irhoud in the northwest and Ethiopia Omo Kibish site in the middle eastern part of Africa. This find shows the importance of the need to keep researching things that have already been discovered, excavated, researched in the past. We need to keep using the latest technology on previously excavated sites, as it will broaden our understanding and bring new information to light. Of course, there are still many, many anthropologists that do not believe that the Djebel Irhoud fossils belong to Homo sapiens, as they do not possess some of the key morphological features like the tall and globular cranial vault and chin on the lower jaw. These features, however, are unequivocally found on the Omo 1 fossils, which is why they can say without any reason of doubt that these fossils at Omo 1 are the earliest modern humans. That's at least a fact, but it does show that the timeline goes back further, which could result in the chances of the Djebel Irhoud fossils being the oldest ever found, if we can date them. But of course, there are even some anthropologists that don't even believe that the fossils from Morocco, from the Djebel Irhoud site, are modern humans. They like to argue that the fossils at Djebel Irhoud belong to an entirely different species, which to me is just ludicrous, but okay. That's my opinion. I do hope that we will get more clarification on the Djebel Irhoud fossils in Morocco in the future. I personally believe that they are indeed modern humans, but it's not for me to decide. We need more research and DNA analysis to be certain that they are indeed Homo sapiens, but until then, we won't be 100% sure. I do love looking into the origins of the modern human lineage, and I will create dedicated videos on the Omo Kibish sites in the future. And of course, I will cover the Djebel Irhoud site. But before I go, I have two subscribers and supporters of the channel who have started a betting pool. Yeah. John Jiff and Vulps Vulps have taken out a bet against each other about when I will reach 100,000 subscribers with the channel. Thanks, guys. John has his bets on May, and Fulps has his bets on July, and they put in $5 a month, and the winner donates the pot to my travel fund. They wanted to ask if anyone else wants to partake in this bet. If so, let me know in the comments down below, and I'll write down a bet sheet to keep track of all the players, and we will see. I would like to note that I personally feel that they both are way too generous with their projections. I personally do not expect to reach 100,000 subscribers before at least New Year's Eve, but if this helps people to subscribe to the channel as well, I won't be complaining. So yeah, let me know. And if you hate the entire idea, then just find Fulps or John Jiff in the comments down below and tell them that you hate this entire idea. If you enjoyed watching, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you'd like to see more of these kind of videos, and click that bell icon if you want to be notified every time I upload. If you haven't seen my previous videos yet, then click the card in the upper right corner, one of the links in the description down below, or click a video in the end card. Also, all my sources are always in the description down below, so if you wonder why I come to certain conclusions or where I get certain dates from, always check out the sources in the description down below. And I would like to say a massive thank you to all my channel members and my patrons. Thank you so much for supporting me and the channel and my work. It means a whole lot to me, and I hope that we can keep this going. And for now, I think that's it. I do want to mention, I saw a TikTok a couple days ago about a guy that was telling the viewers that the official name for Homo sapiens is Homo sapiens sapien. And the guy was a gay guy, so he was making a joke that he therefore is a Homo sapiens sapien, which makes him twice the man as a hetero guy would be. And I kind of like that. But yeah. That's the blooper.